In the spirit of all things ghoulish and ghostly, things you don't want to meet in the dark. Number 9. La Pizzeria. Have you ever experienced the distinct creepy feeling that you're being watched even though you and your family members are the only ones inside the house? Should you happen to live in Brazil, that feeling might be as a result of La Pizzeria lurking around your home. La Pizzeria is a tall, thin woman who scales rooftops before glaring at families who are sitting down for dinner in well-lit dining rooms. If one of the family members goes to bed straight after finishing their meal, she sneaks into the room and waits for them to get drowsy. When they start nodding off, she jumps onto their chest and attacks them. The victim is helpless, trapped beneath La Pizzeria, and can only watch in terror as she starts tearing them apart. Number 8. The Three-Legged Lady of Nash Road. In the dark, a three-legged lady might just look like a woman who's dressed up for a Halloween party. But if you're in Mississippi, she will start chasing your car as you drive down an unfamiliar road. Once she gets close enough for you to really see her, she will start banging on the hood of your car, and you will realize that the third leg is a rotting limb that she's sewn onto her body. At this point, you should drive away as fast as possible. Or, you know, don't drive down unfamiliar roads in Mississippi to begin with. Number 7. Boo Hag. A boo hag makes a vampire seem like a Sunday school picnic. Originating from the Gullah culture, these skinless creatures creep into homes in South Carolina's Low Country region. After finding a hapless victim inside, they clamber onto the person's chest and suck out their breath. If they're feeling particularly vicious, they also tear off the victim's skin and wrap it around themselves to get warm. Here's to fervently hoping that this story is truly just an urban legend. Number 6. The Countess at Cernin Palace. Sometimes evil deeds done by humans reverberate into the afterlife. This certainly seems to be the case with the Countess of Cernin Palace in Prague. In life, the Countess was vain and cruel to the extent that she made shoes out of bread while peasants starved to death and bathed in milk at a time when the substance was unaffordable. It is said that even the demons that surrounded her became weary of her evil acts, and 9 of them eventually dragged her to hell while she was still alive, as punishment for her deeds. Should you feel the inclination to visit the Cernin Palace, you might just encounter her anguished spirit rushing through the corridors, screaming into the night, forever trying to get away from her demon captors. Number 5. The Yellow Ribbon Lady. Ma Fei Wa, or the Yellow Ribbon Lady, is a sad spirit who died a violent death. She spends her afterlife guarding the cemeteries and graveyards in Myanmar, in the form of a woman who has long black hair tied with a yellow ribbon. At the strike of midnight, she lifts a coffin onto her shoulder and heads into the nearest town. There, she drops the coffin onto a chosen doorstep, and soon after, someone inside that house dies. Sadly, it is usually a child. Number 4. Madame Koi Koi. A long time ago, according to legend, a female teacher was murdered by her students in retribution for the torture they suffered at her hands. They gagged her, beat her, and threw her over the school's back fence. They thought they'd gotten away with it, but then gradually, each student involved in the incident disappeared. Only one remained, the one that beat her with a high-heeled shoe, and he told everyone who would listen that he heard high heels walking towards him every night. No one believed him, and when the student went out to confirm the source of the sound one night, he failed to return to his room. He was found beaten to death in the corridor the following morning. Following this incident, some kids were scared enough to transfer to other schools, but Madame Koi Koi, as she was called, soon followed them, took to tormenting them, and caused each one who dared to look at her to vanish into thin air. Number 3. The Water Babies of Massacre Rocks. Long ago, when native villagers inhabited Porticello, Idaho, a severe famine ravaged the area. It became so bad that newborn babies were drowned in a nearby river to spare them a life of starvation. The spot where these massacres took place was aptly named Massacre Rocks, and it is said that if you sit on the banks of the river in silence, you will soon hear the sound of the water babies crying out for their mothers. Another version of the water baby story tells the tale of a race of dwarves who had lived in Utah Lake. These dwarves would make sounds very reminiscent of crying babies, which in turn would lure concerned people into the lake to try and find the source of the crying. For their efforts, they would be dragged into the depths by the fake water babies. Of course, the creepy crying only happens at night when everything is quiet, and unsuspecting victims are even more compelled to rescue what they think is an abandoned baby from the darkness. Number 2. Witwieven. The Netherlands is an amazing travel destination, but it would be wise to stay away from the moors of the northern and eastern parts of the country at night, especially the burial grounds. It is here that a white fog rises and covers the surrounding countryside. If you're unfortunate enough to witness the fog, you'll soon realize that it isn't fog at all, but the souls of the White Whites or Witwieven who are roaming the area surrounding their own graves, unable to find eternal rest. If you, for some reason, feel the urge to walk into their midst, you will never be seen again. Number 1. Devil of the Sea. The Nukalavi, or more ominous, Devil of the Sea, is the most malevolent creature to be found in Scotland. This terrifying being sports both a human head and a horse head. It becomes enraged whenever it smells burning seaweed and will kill entire fields of cattle out of pure anger simply by breathing over the animals. Those who believe they've encountered this monster have said that it has no skin and that black blood visibly flows through its yellow veins. The scariest thing about this demonic creature is that no one knows the form it takes when it's in the ocean. Fortunately, it is confined to the waves whenever it rains, which means you can take your nightly stroll along the beach as soon as the drops start to fall.